In the previous quiz questions, you used your intuition to read through some if-else statements. You figured out what different messages would be printed to the logs based on certain conditions. Now let's look into these statements more formally. If-else statements are called control flow statements. It's named this way because instead of a linear flow of code where one line of code is being executed after another, the control flow statement actually allows us to jump to different parts of the code based on certain conditions. So if this condition is true, meaning the Boolean variable was set to true up here somewhere, then these statements will be executed, and it will skip this block of code. If this condition is false, then we execute these lines of code and then resume the normal linear flow of code after that. Looking at our vocab word glossary, we can look up the phrase if-else statement. One way to think about this is to use an analogy of a train track. A train track has a switch so that given a certain condition, the train will go one way or the other. Similarly, in the if-else statement, if this condition is true, then we'll execute one path of code. If the statement is false, then we'll execute a different path of code. And then afterwards, we're going to resume the normal flow of code. The if statement is the simplest control flow statement. Notice the syntax here. We start with the word if, and then we have parentheses around the condition, and then we have an opening brace, and then a closing brace at the end of the if block of code. In this example of a pizza ordering app, if the user wants the order to be delivered to their home, then we're going to adjust the price to add $5 extra for the delivery charge. Otherwise, if the order is not for delivery, then we just skip this line of code and we don't add the extra charge for delivery. Then in these subsequent lines of code, we can use the total price variable with the correct value. Now the if-else statement is a little more advanced. If the condition in the parentheses is true, then we execute these lines of code. Then we skip this and then continue with the rest of the code. So in this game app, if the user has 0 points, then we're going to update the text view to say loser, and we're going to update the image view to be a sad face. However, if the condition is false, the person has, for example, 100 points, then we're going to skip this block of code and we're going to go down here to the else case. We're going to update the text view to show the word winner, and then we're going to update the image view to show a happy face. Then we're going to continue with these lines of code here. As you can see, the code inside the if statement can contain as many lines of code as we want, similarly with the else statement. If we want more than two possible code paths, we can use an else if statement. You can have as many else if blocks as you want, and then you could just end with an else at the very end. But again, all these else if and else blocks are optional. In our code here, we can fall into one of three possible cases depending on the value of the integer variable item count. Item count just represents the number of items in the shopping cart in our app. Let's start with the first condition. If item count is 12, then 12 is greater than 10, so that is true, and then we would execute the lines of code within this block of code. We would create a toast message that says you get 20% off and show it at the bottom of the screen. Since we fell into this case, then we skip this block, and then we continue with the rest of the code. What would happen if the shopping cart only had 2 items in it? Well, then item count would not be greater than 10. So this would be false, and we would skip this block of code here, and then jump down to the else if statement. Then we would check if 2 is greater than 0, and it is, so then we would fall into this case. We would show a toast message that says, thank you. Since we fell into this case, we're gonna skip this one, and then we can continue with the rest of the code. And lastly, if our shopping cart had 0 items, then this condition would be false because 0 is not greater than 10. This condition would be false because 0 is not greater than 0. And then we would fall into this else case here, and we would show a message that says you have an empty cart. If you ever need a reminder of the syntax of any of these statements, you can just check the official Java documentation. It tells you about the if statement, and here's an example. And then it also shows you the if-else statement, and here's the example. And lastly, there's an example with else-if statements. Based on everything that I've shown you so far, you're probably realizing that Java has a special use for the words if and else. They're Java keywords, and they're used to control how the code is executed, so you can't use these as variable names. From the examples that I showed you, you also may have started to realize that we put different expressions in this test condition here. Any expression is valid as long as it evaluates to true or false. So we can put a Boolean variable in the test condition, or for example, we can compare two values. We can compare two values using any of these equality and relational operators. we can test that two integers are equal to each other or not equal to each other, or greater or less than equal to each other. And here are examples of different test conditions.